What's up, you guys? It's Matt here. So when a lot of people think of travel credit cards, they're thinking of the Platinum card, they're thinking of the CSR, they're thinking of the Altitude Reserve card, and people, you know, they kind of don't look at the cards below that. They really don't look at anything that could be considered a travel card. And I just wanted to bring up a travel card here that I have on my list to be able to review. I want to have every single review on my channel. So this is one of the cards that I really wanted to review. And that card is the Bank of America Travel Rewards credit card. Very simple, very to the point, and we'll get into that in just a second. Now, before I start, I do a giveaway every single week. I give away two Amazon gift cards at the end of the week. So if you're interested in that, all you have to do in order to enter that giveaway is just subscribe to my channel, like at least one video for this week, comment on at least one video for this week, and then you'll be entered in the giveaway with one ticket. If you want multiple tickets, then all you have to do is comment on multiple videos. I really appreciate everybody who comments and likes, who's engaged, so thank you so much. But let's go ahead and get into this breakdown, and you know, then we can go from there. So the Bank of America Travel Rewards credit card, this is more of a mid-level to like medium range travel credit card. And I know some people put travel cards in like the fourth tier when it comes to the tier system, but certain travel cards actually belong in like more of a keeper card or more of like a third tier or second tier, something like that. And this is one of those cards. It's not anything that's, you know, crazy where you get a ton of credits, where you get, you know, the best thing in the world, you get a concierge service, you get all this other stuff. No, you don't get any of that stuff. This is just a very simple credit card. So if you have this credit card, let me know if you like it. I think it's comparable to the Discover Miles card, even though I don't know how far Discover Miles go, but probably a mile, if that's a joke for you. So let's get into the card. So this card has no annual fee. And if you like travel, if you like travel rewards, miles, you know, points, all that stuff, you would rather have no annual fee than an annual fee. Some people prefer an annual fee because they know they get more, but there's some annual fee cards out there that you get absolutely nothing. So don't just go by the fact that they have an annual fee. So no annual fee on this card. It's a good thing. This card earns an unlimited 1.5 points per dollar that you spend on anything, on all purchases. It's not just travel. It's not just, you know, it's anything. It's basically comparable to the Discover card, or it's comparable to the Quicksilver card, but with travel perks in some way. So it's labeled as a travel card, so you get 1.5 points per dollar that you spend. You have no foreign transaction fees on this card. You also get a bonus on this card. Any card that offers you a bonus, especially with no annual fee, is amazing. I like the Propel card, gives you a bonus, no annual fee. You know, I like all of these other cards, and I'm not really saying that these other cards are travel cards. You know, even if the Quicksilver card will give you a bonus, a cash bonus, but they'll give you a bonus. So the Propel card gives you 30,000 points, but we're not talking about that here. But still, if you have a no annual fee card, you're getting a lot out of it. So this card gives you a bonus of 25,000 online bonus points when you spend $1,000 in your first 90 days. That can be used for $250 statement credit towards travel purchases. So that's a good thing. You can basically value it at 1-to-1. So I mean, getting any bonus is going to help you out. You can use it towards travel. You can use it towards your travel stays. You can use it towards all of these different things. So I feel like any bonus is a good thing. You also get a 0% APR for the first 12 billing cycles, for the first 12 months. So the regular APR is 16.74% to 24.74%. So to have zero APR, over anything, it doesn't matter what the APR actually is. It could be 1%. So to have zero APR is better than 1%. So if you have a large purchase, then this would be a card you could put it towards. And you wanted to pay it off in maybe 2-3 months, you have a plan for it, then you could do that. If you have another card, you're not going to be able to do that, and you're going to have to pay interest on it. So you don't want to have to do that. Zero APR is definitely a good thing. I always recommend it for anybody that has any type of debt, actually. To get 12 extra months at zero APR is amazing. But if you have a large purchase, that's the way to go, is zero APR. Also, one more thing, if you are a Preferred Rewards member, you can earn 25% to 75% more points on every purchase. So that's a huge thing to be able to gain more points. I don't care who you are, you want more points. I want more points, you want more points, and we're all going to get more points as long as you're a Preferred Rewards member. So if you bank with Bank of America or you invest with Merrill, you can, get that 25 to 75% more points on every purchase. So this is the card in a nutshell. It's not really anything that's extravagant. It's not the best card in the world, but it is a good card. I like the fact that you get a bonus. I like the fact that you get 1.5 points per dollar that you spend. I like the fact that it has a zero APR. There's so many things that are simple that would help you out in any situation. So this is the reason why I really like this card. It's not something that I am into because this is more basic travel rewards. That's my review, guys. Hopefully you liked this video. If you did, make sure you hit the like button. Also hit the subscribe button for more videos just like this one. And remember that I do a giveaway every single week. I give away 2 Amazon gift cards at the end of the week. And all you have to do in order to get into that giveaway is just comment on at least one video for the week, like at least one video for the week, and also be subscribed to my YouTube channel. If you do all of those things, then you get one ticket in a hat. If you want multiple tickets, then just comment on multiple videos. But that's my video, guys. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. But I'm gonna have to get out of here. And until next time, I'll see you guys later.